This is Louis, aka Tinder God, and I heard you want to have more likes on Tinder. Well, I made a post in my private Facebook group to have my students send their profiles to me. I got a whole ton, I selected 3 of them, and today we're gonna review them so we can see what they're doing well, that gets them more likes. We're gonna see what they're doing bad, which gets them less likes, and then you can do whatever the good stuff they're doing to get more likes yourself on Tinder. So we're gonna jump right into it. We're starting with the first profile, then we'll do 2 more. We'll first look at their pictures and then look at the profile text or the bio, and then we'll see what we can do to get more likes on Tinder. First profile, let's look at the photos and let's dive right into it. This is gonna be the thing with this guy's profile. He has 3 photos. Let's look at them real quick. Bang, bang, bang. Wow. All 3 of them are high quality. They show his face, or in one case, they show his whole body. But that's all they do. Except for this photo, maybe, where he has an owl. So for this guy's photos, he just has 3 photos. He should probably do a 4th or a 5th. He has to tell a story. Where's a cool hobby you have, maybe some friends. Now it's just he's done a photo shoot, and here are some high quality photos of him, and that's it. Let's have a look at his bio. So here's his bio. It says, got all my leadership skills from him, Kim Jong-un. Got kicked in the balls by a horse once. The horse died after 2 days. Taught me how to rap, Lil Pump. This one's obviously a lie, because Lil Pump, he never raps. He's just like, we take over the world, says his goldfish. And then it says, very loyal, by Cesar Millan. That's the dog training guy, right? And then it says, no mice, they always get lost. Honestly, I don't know what that means. Okay, so about his bio, this is a very common mistake when guys try to make a good bio. You see, he's doing the review type of bio, where Kim Jong is talking about him, Lil Pump is talking about him, his goldfish and Cesar Millan are talking about him. Many guys will say something as, oh, guy of the year, New York Times, or best boyfriend ever, says Playboy, or whatever. It's where people are talking about you. So he found this, he was like, oh, it's really funny, I'm taking this, putting it into my profile. But at the same time, he found this Chuck Norris type of line, where a horse kicked him in the balls and then the horse died because his balls are so... And he was like, oh, I'm gonna put that in as well. So there's the reviews going on, but then the second line is this random Chuck Norris joke that's crammed in there, because that was funny as well. And then he adds the thing about the mice, which I still don't understand what it means, which is also a good tip for you, by the way. So if you're thinking and you're like, oh yeah, this is really funny, I'm gonna put it in my profile, double check with your friends. So my main advice for him, stick to one type of bio and really own it, make it a good one. Don't try to combine 3 jokes into one chaotic, inconsistent bio. And lastly, a long bio can work, and we're gonna see a really long bio in the 3rd profile, but a short profile will usually do better, especially if you're new to Tinder. Backward step. By the way, I made an exclusive download for you. It's a checklist that you can read while looking at your profile, and it will tell you how many likes you're gonna get on Tinder, or if it's gonna do well at all. So you just look at the checklist, look at your profile, make a better profile and get more likes. Download it in the link here or here, or I don't know where my editor is gonna put it, but download it. Yeah. Profile number 2. For profile number 2, we have this very muscular, handsome boy. So he's in some poorly photoshopped jungle, feeding a banana to a gorilla, looking all jacked. He has this face like, wow, I'm the man. I think this is a great photo, something that pops out when you're just swiping, and all of a sudden there's this semi-naked guy. It's a good starter. If the rest of your profile is really serious, then something like this could work. So rest of the photos. Let's talk about this one. He's just in a t-shirt, an elevator, in a skiing park. He's pretty badass. He has no cold, so this makes him more masculine, and it shows a cool hobby. Then there's this one, he's mountain biking with 2 girls, it seems, so he does have female friends. He's not showing them in the photo in a way like, oh, look at me, I have all these girls. It's just super casual. And he's feeding one water, kind of funny. The colors in the picture are not very good. This is a debatable photo. Here he is on a boat. He's looking a little bit sad. There's a motor helmet next to him, so again, it shows some masculinity. Just the vibe of this photo is a little bit down. And in general, you want happy vibes. The more happy vibes in your photo, people catch those vibes when they're swiping, they like it, and pfft. And then we have this one. This is actually his first. This is him bungee jumping, and you can't see this right now, but it's one of those moving clips, so you actually see him. So these were his photos, and the one where he's in the jungle feeding a banana, this actually is the second one here, but it should have been the first one. He just switched things around last minute. So this guy's photos, not perfect yet, but it's better than the last one, because this guy is telling a story with his pictures. Bio. Some say the first picture is photoshopped. It is not true. I live in a fairy tale jungle. experience seeker, no butt stuff on the first date, and then a whole bunch of emojis. First of all, some say the picture is photoshopped. It's not true. I live in a fairy tale jungle. I think it's funny. It engages with his photo, so it makes people look back, which is a good thing. But it's kind of confusing as well, because it says some say the first picture is photoshopped, but this, as we saw earlier, it's not his first, because the first is the bungee jump. It's the second picture. Better just have it 100% correct. The less confusion, the better. Then it says experience seeker, and this is something I don't like at all. Experience seeker, wanderlust, lover of food, all those general things that don't really say much. This is not good to have in your profile. And then he goes, no butt stuff on the first date. Personally, I think it's funny, maybe because I think all vulgar words like butt stuff and asshole are funny. What is a big deal here though is that he wrote butt wrong. It has one T. That kind of ruins the joke. Please be careful with spelling and grammar. There's some girls that find it a massive turn off. And then lastly, there's just a whole bunch of emojis. All these emojis, it's very girly as well, and it doesn't add anything. Don't do it. So my advice to this guy, the second profile, ditch the experience seeker and ditch the emojis, and just keep the thing about the Photoshop picture and the no butt stuff, or maybe even better, just keep one. Keep it short and sweet. Third profile. Okay, here we have this guy. He has way more photos than the other guys. He has 8 to be exact. First one, and this is what I was talking about earlier in the photo. This is the perfect crop. We have his head and we have his torso. Second photo is the same guy looking very jacked in some sort of gymnastics move, almost naked in the dark in a park. I'm not sure if it's creepy or if it's artistic. Third photo I really like. You can see him being a pilot. I mean, being a pilot is pretty badass. Fourth photo absolutely has to go. It's the same like the first photo, but just way worse. The crop is worse, he's looking worse, his style is worse, the quality of the photo is worse. Just get rid of this. Next photo, him being a cyclist. Why would you just be in your garden with your bike when you could have a photo where you're actually riding your bike through the mountains, through a snowstorm or whatever, something that tells a really cool tale, while this is just like, hey, I bike. Next photo, him flexing his back on the beach. With this guy, I mean, he has a really good body, he's super jacked, but he's already shown this in 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 photos, so this is going a bit in overkill mode, right? And then we have the next photo, it's his 10 years challenge. Usually it's you evolving from a pre-puberty boy into a masculine guy, and all of a sudden you're handsome and it's really awesome. But what he's doing, 2009, a girl's hair is being pulled, and then 2019, a girl's... We'll talk more about it soon. Okay, let's have a look at his bio right here. When I was young, girls didn't like it when I pulled their hair. Funny how things change. Tired of swiping left. 1.93 meters. Training daily, very much into personal development. Then he links his Instagram, which is also linked below. So if you want people to actually go to your Instagram, you have to do what this guy is doing, and you have to put your name tag in your bio. Then he says, no, not a catfish, as far as I know. And then at the bottom of the bio, he says, according to scientific research, there is a 90% chance that the sole reason you are here on Tinder is for the sake of emotional confirmation. In that particular case, there is a 99% chance we won't match anyway. So this guy's bio is really long, it's too long, and there's a lot of information. First thing, when I was young, girls didn't like it when I pulled her hair, blah blah blah. This is kind of unnecessary to put in your bio, because you already have a photo showing this. This is overkill, and overkill is gonna be the general vibe of this profile. He has multiple photos flexing. It makes you wonder, maybe this guy is a bit insecure. Why is he trying so hard to show how cool that is? It's best to tone it down a little. Remove some photos, pick 1, max 2 photos where you can see your body. Make the bio way shorter, maybe do 1 joke. Information such as training daily, that's totally irrelevant. Tired of swiping left, no, not a catfish. Do 1 of both, or maybe 0. When I was young, girls didn't like it, blah, blah, blah. You've already shown it in the photos. Relax, man. You're a cool guy, but you're trying to show it too much. And then last but not least, the part about the research. It's interesting that he's mentioning this. It's cool that he's reading up on the fact. I've read some studies and this is indeed true. I mean, 90% is debatable, but there will always be women who are on Tinder just to see where they're at in the market. Do guys still like them? But even then, those women who are on Tinder for validation, you can still get a good chunk of them out on a date if you have a cool profile and you know how to make good conversation. Backwards then! Okay, bro. Apply all the advice from this video to your profile, fine-tune it, make it better, and you'll definitely get more likes on Tinder. I'm not sure if you can see, but my nose is dripping, my hands are frozen. toes are frozen. It's actually freezing cold here in Belgium, so I'm gonna go and get a hot chocolate. Give this video a like if you want to support me, and subscribe for a bigger penis.